This is how I color in anime drawings, just like how Japanese anime studios do. I'm teaching myself the Japanese anime studio pipeline, and I've managed to emulate a method in coloring in anime cells using Clip Studio Paint. Keep in mind, this is not the only method of doing things. My team and I have made multiple anime-style animations over the years, and I'm going to be teaching you my method to coloring in these frames quickly and efficiently. First things first, we need to set up our animation cell folder. In your animation timeline, create a new animation folder and then create a new folder inside of that. Here is where we will set up our layers. First, we have the top layer, which will be our line art layer. This will be where you draw the black line art and only the black line art. This is very important for later. An optional bonus tip: if you go over here to the Change Layer Color button, you can change the entire layer's color to be solid black, so that no matter what color you might have accidentally selected, you can only draw in black on this layer. This is to help prevent you from accidentally drawing on the wrong layer. Next, we have the next layer down, which will be where we put our flat colors. You can leave this one blank for now. Finally, we have the bottom layer, which will be for our colored lines, also called color trace. If you want to follow the previous bonus tip, you can create two color trace layers and set it up so that one is pure blue and one is pure red, and you just need to remember to select the correct layer that you're coloring on. These colors are specific to anime production, but if you don't care about the specifics, you can use any color you wish as long as it's not pure black or pure white. If you want, you can set up an auto action in Clip Studio Paint that automatically creates this folder structure for you so that you don't need to perform all the tedious stuff over and over again. It makes the process go even faster. Now, this next step might seem weird, but trust me, anime studios actually do something like this in real life. During the anime creation process, animators will draw their line art with clean, dark lines like this. Usually, this is done with pencil, since a good majority of anime studios still use pencil and paper to this day. Otherwise, they'll draw them digitally on a program like Clip Studio Paint, OpenTunes, or TV Paint. These lines get scanned or imported into software like Redis Paintman and converted into these digital aliased lines that look all pixely. This way, during the coloring process, the coloring team can easily just fill in the spaces all the way to the black lines without any weird transparency issues. Sure, there's going to be little pixel holes here and there, but it's the job of the colorist to fix the lines and fill in all the gaps. In order to emulate this process, I use a specific set of CSP auto actions provided by the YouTube channel NikaCH in order to convert the lines to the proper format. These auto actions do take some time to get used to, so I highly recommend watching this video on their channel that details step by step how to set it up and how to use it. If you don't want to do that, that's why I set up the folder structure the way that it is. All you have to do is set your brush settings to turn off anti-aliasing so that you're drawing with the pixeled lines directly. Obviously, you're drawing the black lines on the line art layers and the red and blue lines on the color trace layers. Speaking of folder structure, this is where you can finally start filling things in. Set your paint bucket tool so that it has anti-aliasing and auto-scaling turned off, and you want to make sure that you have your bucket tool set to reference the folder. This way, it specifically targets only the line art layer and the color trace layer when coloring things in. Once you have all that set up, make sure that you have your flat color layer selected, and then start coloring things in. Of note, there will likely be small pixel gaps in your line art, so be sure to fill in every one of them. Anime studios go through meticulous checks to make sure that not a single pixel is out of place, so if it happens to the professionals, it's okay that it happens to you. Just fill everything in. Something else that this folder structure also helps with is that when you paint the red and blue lines, it automatically colors over the lines because those are separated below the flat colors. This makes things much more efficient, and you can go back and change things if you feel like the lines need to be adjusted or moved. As a bit of a side note, to the people on TikTok that were screaming at me, why don't you just increase the area scaling? Or why don't you just automatically change the color of all the lines? Let me explain. If you have area scaling turned on, there may be a chance that it doesn't fill in everything properly and you're gonna have to go through and color things in again. Or it might be the case that the colors accidentally bleed over the red and blue lines. This may not be what the original animator intended, and it might mess up the proportions of the lines and colors if things are slightly out of place. The easiest solution is the most straightforward solution, which is just to color things in as they are intended. Also, to the people that were asking about changing all the line colors, let's look at this example. If I try to change the color of all of the blue lines, it's going to color in all the blue lines throughout the entire drawing. Obviously, you could use a lasso tool or try to restrict things to just one section, but it's a lot more work than it needs to be. Again, it's much easier to simply color things in as they are intended from the character color reference sheet. And now we have to convert things back to the smooth lines. As I mentioned in a previous video, anime studios will provide the post-production team with all of the drawings, and then they put everything into software like After Effects and make adjustments from there. They use plugins like OLM Smoother to return anti-aliasing to the lines. Obviously, we currently cannot import OLM Smoother to Clip Studio Paint, as that is an After Effects / Photoshop exclusive plugin, but we can definitely make use of Clip Studio Paint's smoothing feature. To start off, merge the animation drawing to a new layer. Go up to Filter, Blur, Smoothing, and then you can see that the lines become less pixeled. Obviously, you can run this process again and again to increase the smoothness if you're not happy with the initial result. There's also an auto action also included from Nika's CSP tools called Copy Smoothing that does all of this in one step. Again, this is optional and you could watch Nika's video in order to know how to set this up, but the auto action is basically just what I described already, so you don't need to worry about that. And you just repeat this for every single frame in the animation and you have a fully smoothed out animation. One recommendation that I would also add is if you're using Clip Studio Paint, you can create a new animation folder for each new step in the pipeline. In this case, I have all of the coloring steps on one animation folder, and then I create a new animation folder on top of that and create new keyframes to match the existing ones. I then run this copy smoothing process into the new animation folder, and that way everything is very cleanly laid out on one animation timeline instead of within a bunch of folders. Of course, this is absolutely optional. You don't have to do it this way. This is just something that I do with my process. And it also has the added benefit of when I'm exporting things, I can actually have different export folders for the different steps of the animation process. This would allow me to create GIFs of the different steps from storyboarding to rough animation to coloring and so on. And if you're wondering more about the anime production pipeline, check out this video where I talk about my animation team's process from beginning to end. Or check out this other video to watch one of my latest animations.